Hey guys, Miro here. In this video, I'm going to experiment with geometry nodes and curves. Well, you may ask, how's that possible, as we can't assign geometry modifier on curve object and accessing curves geometry via object info node doesn't work yet? Well, I cheated a little bit by using a curve and array modifier, but I promise this is for a good reason, as the secondary mission of this video is also to show developers what are the use cases and where the bottlenecks in the current workflow are. I found out that some initial work to support curves in geometry nodes has already started, so I hope, dear developers, this video will be valuable for you as well. So let's get started. I created a simple road just as a visual reference. It's made of a simple textured plane, which width I control with geometry nodes, and then I array it along a curve. Even though this approach is far from ideal for doing advanced roads or road networks, it would be nice to have even this simple way of making roads covered by geometry nodes. Next, I use the same spline to sketch the street lamps along the road. To do so, I again take the advantage of using array and curve modifier to get very thin plane copied along the curve, so then I can scatter points on it, and when changing minimum distance on point distribute node, this allows me to simulate curve sampling at constant distance. This is of course not the correct way of curve sampling, but perfectly serves the cause. So curve sampling at constant distance could be one of the modes. The other could be to fit the spline, so instead of setting a distance, user would set exact count of points sampled on a curve. So in case user sets 5, exactly 5 points fits the curve. The fact that I'm scattering points on faces here allows me to access normal of each scattered point. So then I can offset them from the center line as well as rotate them the way that lamps always face the road. So it would be great to have access to these normals on sampled points from a built-in attribute. Okay, let's jump into another use case. To edit terrain under the road, I use the same curve again, and obviously curve and array modifier to get a mesh copied along the curve. In this case, mesh is just 3 faces, or more like 4 pairs of vertices, which position I control with geometry nodes. And finally, terrain sticks to this mesh using shrink wrap modifier, so effect like this can be achieved. Unfortunately, I can't control the shift or distance from curve per control point from geometry nodes right now. I can do this only via radius property on selected curve's control point, and this is where custom attributes would come in handy. So the same way as we can create and edit float values per vertex on a mesh object and then access it as custom attributes within geometry nodes, we should be able to create custom attributes on curve objects, say from within this panel, or via Python API, we can already do so for mesh objects, and then be able to edit them. I'm not suggesting having weight pane mode for curves, but something similar to setting a value for a vertex group, but on selected control points, is in my opinion a way to go. Okay, that's it guys. As you could see, all of my use cases cover only landscape development features, but I believe that this video helps to ignite broader discussion, which brings even more examples and use cases from various fields. I would like to thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't done so yet. See you soon guys. Ciao.